డియర్ స్టూడెంట్స్, ఇన్విటేషన్ టు సైకాలజీ మాడ్యూల్ నెంబర్ 1. దిస్ ఇస్ కె శ్రీనివాసాచారి, లెక్చరర్ ఇన్ సైకాలజీ. టుడే వీఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు డిస్కస్ అబౌట్ ది సైన్స్ విచ్ స్టడీస్ అబౌట్ హ్యూమన్ బిహేవియర్. ఇన్ యువర్ ఎడ్యుకేషనల్ జర్నీ యు హ్యావ్ స్టడీడ్ మెనీ సైన్సెస్ విచ్ హెల్ప్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ ది ఎక్స్టర్నల్ వరల్డ్. సైకాలజీ ఈజ్ సంథింగ్ డిఫరెంట్. It studies internal world. Learning objectives. After finishing this module, you will learn meaning of psychology, definitions of psychology, goals of psychology, understanding the nature and scope of the psychology. Welcome to the study of psychology. Psychology is an extremely exciting and challenging field of knowledge. It continues to grow at an accelerating pace each year, and it continues to provide answers to basic questions about the human condition. Psychology has enormous potential. It offers us the hope of both understanding and improving our lives, our communities, and our planet. We are eager to share with you the knowledge that psychology has uncovered thus far and the initiatives that will chart its course into the future. We hope that you will come to share your fascination with psychology, and that many of you will study it at advanced levels, moving perhaps to its forefront in the 21st century. Psychology is both a field of study and a means of improving the quality of life. Its range of inquiry is enormous. Meaning and definitions of psychology. The word psychology, coined by Rudolf Giocchi in the year of 1590 AD. Psychology, the word derived from two Greek words. Psyche means breath or soul. Logos means study. Thus, literally, psychology means the study of soul or science of the soul. The symbol for psychology is the Greek letter psi. The subject matter of psychology is affect, behavior, and cognition. According to earlier psychologists, the function of psychology was to study the nature, origin, and destiny of the human soul. But soul is something metaphysical. It cannot be seen, observed, and touched. And we cannot make scientific experiments on soul. In the 18th century, psychology was understood as the science of mind. William James defined psychology as the science of mental processes. But the word mind is also quite ambiguous, as there was confusion regarding the nature and functions of mind. Modern psychologists defined psychology as the science of consciousness. James Sully defined psychology as the science of the inner world. William Wilhelm Wundt defined psychology as the science which studies the internal experiences. But there are three levels of consciousness: consciousness, subconsciousness, and unconsciousness. And so this definition also was not accepted by some. The psychology first lost its soul, then its mind, and then its consciousness. At present, only its behavior exists. William McDougall defined psychology as the science of behavior. W.B. Pillsbury and J.B. Watson also defined psychology as the science of behavior. Modern psychologists defined psychology as the scientific study of behavior and mental processes. This definition contains three key ideas. One is scientific, second one is behavior, and the third is mental processes. Like meaning of familiar terms, each of these is used in a scientific way by psychologists. Scientific refers to fact that the study of psychology is based on information collected through a set of systematic procedures known as the scientific method. The information collected is referred to as data, specifically defined as records of the observations or measurements in a study. Second one is behavior is an activity that can be observed, recorded, and measured. This includes first what living beings do, that is their actual movements in time and space. For example, smiling, sucking, and sleeping are all behaviors commonly seen in babies. Behavior also includes that people say or write, their reports of their fears or their desires or behaviors. In addition, behavior includes physiological or bodily changes such as elevations in blood pressure or alterations in the electrical activity of the brain. For example, equipment measuring brain activity is attached to a person's head and it begins emitting more signals of the sort called alpha waves. We observe that a change in behavior has taken place. Third one is mental processes. Mental processes include thoughts, memories, emotions, motivations, dreams, and beliefs. Although it may seem obvious that psychologists should investigate mental processes, the study of these processes presents special problems in that they cannot be directly observed, recorded, or measured. Because of this, some psychologists often excluded mental processes from the study of psychology. Since then, however, psychologists have developed many methods for studying these processes. Psychology as